So the thing that's going to affect your open rate the most is probably going to be your subject line. And just far too often, I see people overthinking and overdoing their subject lines. So my recommendation is write that subject line as if you're sending that email to like a friend or a family member. That's going to help you not overthink it and just keep it more casual. Because when you overthink your subject lines, your recipient can tell. Like for instance, if I receive an email and every first letter of each word is capitalized, to me, that triggers a red flag in my mind that the person that sent this to me, they don't know me, we don't have a relationship. It's too formal. I'm just not gonna open it.
The reason it's a mess in here right now is because we just went live for the Bombcast in our new set, just Jason's office.
I don't send a lot of emails, so like my only thought on increasing open rates is just create good content in the emails. Because if they open an email and there's value in there and they like it, and then you send them another one, they're more likely to open the next one because the first one was a good experience, and then just keep doing that.
I heard that emojis give you better open rates in your subject lines, but I was a bit skeptical if the emojis would be too childish or unprofessional. So I did an A/B test on a large email that we sent out. And sure enough, the emoji subject line won, so the emojis caused more opens. So that's something that I think we'll think about doing again in the future. We only used two emojis. I think if you have, you know, 10 emojis, it just looks like way too much, too spammy. And I don't think I'd want to do it on every single email send. Keep it as a special thing for those special occasions and really pick emojis that match the main message. But that's something new I'm excited about.
Young Jason.
For me, I'm thinking about engagement rates a lot with emails because I'm sending out our newsletter every 2 weeks. And newsletters are things that like people often debate, are they worth it? They still relevant? Do people read them? And we do see a lot of like good responses on our newsletter, and they are totally worth the ROI for us. So we're messing around with those analytics and seeing that anytime we have photos with people's faces in them, we get a 78.8% increase in engagement and clicks on our newsletter place. So I definitely recommend people start using more faces. Stop with the technology, like get past that and just use real people, like real people in your office, real people behind the scenes. Just use what you have and you'll see great results.
Subject lines are great for driving open rates. They're what your recipient sees right away. But something that's often overlooked when sending an email is the pre-header text. This is that 30 to 50 characters that's right after the subject line in the recipient's inbox. You can use this area to allude or start talking about what's actually inside that email that's of value. It gives them a reason to open it. So next time you're about to send an email, if you're doing a one-to-many send or a mass email send, most email service providers provide an area for you to put in pre-header text. If you're doing a one-to-one send, it's gonna just take the first part of your email that you're sending and put it into that pre-header text. So next time you send an email, think about using that.